One of the best things about having no fans is that it's a little easier to hear the communication that's happening on the court between players and coaches. As I was watching the Clippers and Celtics matchup, I noticed some interesting talk that I want to show you guys, and it starts with the last 6 minutes of the game. As Paul George brings the ball up, you hear Brad Stevens saying,
"From the field, both teams are 50% or better."
This is a common set that teams run where they can have the initial ball handler curl around two screens. In this case, it's Paul George that's about to do that, and you can see that Stevens points it out. He tells Tatum to come around, which means no switch. As the ball gets swung, Brown gets caught ball watching, which gets Batum a good look, but it doesn't go in, so the Celtics get a break. Now on the way down, Brad Stevens calls a play, and then you can see him pointing at Brown, who's in the corner, and telling him to go to the other side of the floor. You can see Brown in the corner being like, "What?" Because if you see the alignment, it appears Ojale is going to set a screen for Tatum on the right side, and Kemba may be setting a screen on the other side for Brown, so that's why he's confused. It doesn't matter though, as Lou Will gambles for a steal, and Tatum gets a wide open three to put the Celtics up 9. After a Celtics miss, the Clippers try to run and get a mismatch with Paul George and Robert Williams. I'm going to play this clip first with some hot mics and then explain what's happening.
George one-on-one with Williams. George, the handles, off the cross. George, corner pop, doesn't go.
And that's what happens, I...
Okay, so the first thing Brad Stevens says is to stay down. Big men have a tendency to jump into guards and forwards on pump fakes, so he's telling Robert Williams to not jump on a shot fake. The next thing he says is help, help, which is directed towards Ojale and Brown, who are ready to help on any drive to cut George off. You can see once PG is in the paint, there are basically 5 Celtics around him to make it hard for him to pass or shoot. His pass to Beverly is off, and George doesn't get a good shot off. Jaylen Brown yells box out to secure the rebound. With 3 minutes left in the game, Kemba runs a dribble handoff with Jason Tatum to get Nicholas Batum as his primary defender. After not being able to shake Batum, he elects to pass it to the corner where George deflects it. As the Celtics are going back to their huddle, Brown's basically telling Kemba to go get the ball, and Walker saying, that's my fault, I put that on me. And Brown is right. In this position, you have Paul George in the corner with Semi Ojale, and Celtics fans know this guy sucks. The spacing is off on the left-hand side, but you can see Kemba just standing there. Even if that pass to Ojale is not deflected, there's not many things you can do from there, so that's why Brown's telling Kemba to go help Tatum and get the ball. Alright, so here, Reggie Jackson dribbles the ball down, and he tries to shake Kemba before trying a pick and roll until he realizes that he's stuck. Once Paul George gets the ball, Brad Stevens yells,
"Clear it for George, 10 to shoot."
So even when Reggie Jackson tries cutting to get Tatum distracted, notice how he stays in the same area and points to Tice to pick up Jackson in the paint. The Clippers try running a pick and fade with Batum, but Tatum's right there to pick him up. This leads to a scramble situation and pretty good defense until Tice commits a stupid foul. Here's another angle of it. Tice clearly taps Beverly's arm as he's going up, and not surprisingly enough, he gets benched for Robert Williams after that foul. So hopefully you guys got a glimpse of how players and coaches communicate in late game situations. If you would want more of this type of content, I could do a series on it with different teams. Besides that, if you enjoyed the video, please like and subscribe, and I'll see you guys next time. Peace.